The St. Patrick's Day event can be really hard and annoying if you're trying to complete towns quickly and get lots of grand prize progress too. Luckily, it doesn't need to be. I've made a spreadsheet linked in the description that helps you out during the event so that you can get all the rewards you want. You'll need to make a copy of the spreadsheet for each world, and you'll find yourself on the How to Use the Spreadsheet page. This video is linked right there, as well as other event information and links to the written tutorials for each of the components of the spreadsheet. The page you'll spend the most time on is the interface. It has the individual strategies for each town, as well as some extra information about finishing towns or the mini-challenges. The most important component is the to-do list and current tasks tracker. It's designed so that you can put it to the side of the screen, and all you have to do is follow the recommendations and check them off once you complete them. The current tasks tracker will also update as you do so. Green items are the actual tasks in the minigame that you need to complete. Yellow items are my recommendations for when and how far to level buildings and managers. And red items are the ones that I recommend skipping to save on time or pots of gold. Now, in this event, there are three separate task lists, each with slightly different requirements. You can choose which variant you have, 1, 2, or 3, in the town selection box. If you don't know which town you're on, that's fine. We'll talk more about how to figure that out later. If it's your first town of the event, I also have a recommended first town strategy where you skip most of the tasks in order to finish the town much sooner. Once you enter progress on the grand prize page, this option will disappear. As you check off tasks, the tasks completed tracker will update to show you just how many tasks you've finished so far of the recommended amount for each town variant. Similarly, we have the pots of gold spent tracker so that you can plan for how many more pots of gold you will need to finish the town. Towards the bottom of these boxes, you'll find the reset button for the to-do list. Only check the box once you've completed your current town. It will reset all the checkboxes, erasing your progress if you didn't mark it on the grand prize page first. Use with caution. Next is the optimal levels box. Here it will show what level each building should currently be at based on where you are in your tasks, as well as which you should be currently leveling, those that are highlighted in green. Now, what if you don't know which town you're on? If you're playing on the browser version of the game, the FOE Helper browser extension will automatically tell you, but if you don't use the extension or are on mobile, simply enter the three tasks you currently have into the What Town Am I On box, and it will figure out the correct town. Choose this in the town selection box to get the correct tasks list. Once you finish a town, you'll want to head over to the grand prizes page. Here you can track your overall progress and goal, as well as being able to see the entire list of grand prizes. When you finish your current town, update the progress tracker with the number of tasks you completed. This will update your stats, which will track the town you're on, and the number of tasks you've completed so far. New this time, you can also choose a goal for the number of towns you want to complete, based on the strategy you choose. Based on this goal, a progress bar will appear. Green means that you're ahead of your target, yellow means that you're on target, and red means that you're behind. If you find yourself ahead of your target, you may want to go for more progress, but if you're behind your target, it might be smart to choose a lower goal and use some pots of gold on end-of-town boxes. How do you know what your target number of towns should be, though? Luckily for you, I've got a tool for that on the strategies page. The recommended strategies are the easiest to follow for clear rewards. Pick which one has the rewards you'd prefer, and you're set. Lastly, in case you're curious, you can see some more event information on the tasks list page. This includes, of course, the unannotated task lists for each town variant, and you'll also find my recommended manager levels for each town variant here. And I've added the recommendations for the mini challenges here again, too. Now, if you're curious to learn a little bit more about the event as a whole, check out my main event announcement video linked in the description with the spreadsheet. Join my Discord server if you'd like to suggest any tools to add to the spreadsheet or get help on how to use it. And as always, I'll see you all next time.